I'm going to show you the fastest possible way to get not just up and running, but building real-world applications with Next.js. We're going to use the official Supabase template, which comes with a hosted Postgres database and cookie-based authentication configured for you out of the box. And the entire stack is, well, free. So let's get into it.
Using npx, let's run the create-next-app package and specify the example with-supabase. The name of our project is going to be notes, and once that's finished, we can change into our notes directory and then open it up in VS Code so we can see this template has come with a whole bunch of auth stuff already configured for us, which is great. So to get this up and running, we can run npm run dev, and then we can open up localhost over port 3000 in our browser. And you can see I wasn't lying. This is in fact the fastest way to build apps with Supabase and Next.js. Now, if we scroll down a little bit, we can see the next steps to connect this Next.js application to a Supabase project. So let's head over to database.new and create our Supabase project. My organization for this project is going to be Dijon Musters, my name is going to be notes, and I'm going to click here to generate a secure password. Now make sure you copy this into a password manager because this is the only time you will actually see this password. For my region, I'm going to select Sydney as this is closest to my geographical location, but obviously you would want that to be as close as possible to your users or the rest of your application. So I'm going to create my new project. And then if we go back to our Next.js project, we can see we also need to declare these environment variables. So we need to rename .env.example to be .env.local. So we can do that over in VS Code. If we have a look at our project and in the rootmost directory, there is this .env.example. Let's rename this one .env.local. And then we need our Supabase URL and our Supabase anon key, which we can get from the Supabase dashboard. While our project is still spinning up, it's on this landing page. So we have our anon key here, and let's paste that back over in VS Code. And then if we scroll down a little bit, we have our project's URL. So let's copy that from here, paste it here, give this one a save, and then we can close that file. We don't need to think about it again. So back over in the Supabase dashboard, we can see our project is now up and running. So if we weren't on that landing screen, if you come down to project settings and then under API settings, we can see our project's anon key and also our project's URL. So now back over in our Next.js application, you can see our next steps have automatically been updated and we've configured everything we need to be able to sign up our first user. So let's head over to the sign up page, and I'm going to sign up my John at supabase.com user who has a super secure password, and I'm going to click sign up, and I get this error because the John at supabase.com user is not authorized. And this is because when you're using the default Supabase SMTP server, we have some restrictions in place as to who you can send emails to. Once you push this out to production, you can configure your own custom SMTP settings, and we'll look at that in a different video. But for now, we just need to head over to the Supabase dashboard and scroll up in the sidebar, click this little Supabase icon, navigate to your organization on the left, go over to team, and then invite anyone you would like to be able to send emails to while building out your application. So in this case, that's that John at supabase.com user. So this adds this user to my Supabase organization, which means we can use them as a test user while we're building out our application. So now that we've invited this user, let's head over to their email account where they've received an email that looks something like this. So we'll say, join this organization. And so once Cooler John has accepted our invitation, they will now be able to authenticate with our Next.js application. So anyone in your Supabase organization you can send emails to and use during testing. If you want to send an email to someone outside of your Supabase organization, then you just need to configure custom SMTP settings, which again, we'll look at in another video. But for now, if we go over to our Next.js application and sign up our John at supabase.com user again with their super secure password and click sign up, we'll see that success message. Thanks for signing up. Please check email for a verification link. And so that looks something like this, where we need to confirm our email address. And now you'll see we've automatically been redirected to this protected page, which we can only see as an authenticated user. So this is all the information about our Supabase user, and our next steps have dynamically been updated to create some tables and insert some data. So let's copy this block of SQL, which creates a table called notes and inserts some example notes, and head back over to the Supabase dashboard. And if we go to all projects, we can search through our ludicrous number of projects for our notes example, and it was the one from our Dijon Masters organization. We can then head over to the SQL editor to be able to paste in some raw SQL and then click run to run that against our Postgres database. And we see success, no rows returned, which means everything's all good, which we can confirm by going over to the table editor. And we can see we now have this table for notes, which has our three example notes. So let's get this Supabase data displaying in our Next.js application. So back over in VS Code, let's create a new file in the app directory called notes/page.tsx. And this one is going to export out a page that displays all of our notes, but we don't like writing things for ourselves if someone else is going to write it. So if we go back to our Next.js application and then scroll down on our next step section, we can see a little code snippet for how we would actually fetch these notes from Supabase. So let's copy this one and go back over to VS Code, paste it in. And now ESLint is yelling at us because it's saying there is no .from property on a promise for a Supabase client. And this is because we need to update our code example, because now when we call the create client function as of Next.js 15, this returns a promise for our client rather than just our Supabase client. So we just need to await our call to create client and our red squiggly disappears. So now we can give this one a save and go back over to the browser. And rather than this protected page, we want to navigate to our new notes page. And we can see those three example notes from Supabase rendering in this very pretty JSON blob in our Next.js application. So since we have authentication and authorization already baked into our application, let's take this one step further and make this a protected page. Because currently, if we were to sign out and manually head over to that /notes page, we can see that data from Supabase, even though we're not currently authenticated. Now, that might not be a problem, but in this case, we're going to protect this data so only authenticated users are able to see these notes. So back over in VS Code, we can have a look at the protected page and see this is doing a similar thing to create our Supabase client, but then we're making a call to supabase.auth.getUser. And if we don't have a user, then we're redirecting to the sign-in page. If we do have a user, then we just continue on and render the protected page. So basically, we just want to copy this chunk of code and paste it over in our notes page. So after we create our Supabase client, we make a call to get our Supabase user. And then if we don't have a Supabase user, then we want to redirect to the sign-in page. And this red squiggly is just telling us that we need to import that redirect function from next/navigation. Now, if we save this page and go back over to the browser, we'll see we've automatically been redirected to this sign-in page. And if we try to manually go to that /notes page, it automatically redirects us again back to this sign-in page. So the only way that we can actually see our notes is by signing in as one of our users and manually navigating to our notes page. And this works fantastically if we have a brand new Next.js project that's entirely greenfield and we're starting from scratch, which the majority of the time isn't the case. So how would we migrate an existing Next.js application across to use all of this awesome Supabase authy stuff? Well, I would start by using this template as a really good example of how to do this properly. And really, if you were to copy across this utils/supabase folder, this will give you helper functions for creating a Supabase instance in a client component or middleware or a server component. You'll also need this middleware.ts file, which automatically updates our Supabase session before it hits any of our server components. And the last one you'll need is under auth, and then this callback route, which is where the user gets redirected after they've completed the authentication bit. And so it exchanges an auth code for the user's session and then redirects them to the page we want them to see after they sign in. So this /protected page, for example. But those three bits basically give you all of the configuration and helper functions that you need to get up and running with Next.js and Supabase quickly, and then you can just use the rest of these pages and this actions file as inspiration for how you might want the DX to feel when the user is authenticating.
To take this to the next level, check out this video right here. We build an entire SaaS product from scratch and have it taking very real subscription payments in prod in less than 15 minutes. But until next time, keep building cool stuff.